It's time to decide whether to renew the special education millage. Every 8 years since 1990, voters who live within the boundaries of the West Shore Educational Service District have renewed the special education millage that generates funds for special education in our three-county region. Tuesday, May 4 is Election Day. This is the date voters in our West Shore ESD region will be asked whether to renew the 1 mil tax levy for another 8 years. Based on current property values, the 1 mil renewal would provide $3.4 million annually to fund special education programs and services in the three counties served by the West Shore ESD, covering 2,000 square miles in the counties of Lake, Mason, and Oceana. The ESD serves 1,400 students with disabilities in 9 school districts. The West Shore ESD is proud to partner with its 9-member school districts. When the costs of specific programs and services are shared, they are reduced. Remember, Tuesday, May 4 is Election Day. This is when you will decide whether to approve the 1 mil 8-year renewal levy, which has funded special education in our three-county region since 1990. Please note also that the renewal request on May 4 is not a request to raise taxes. The millage renewal proposal on the ballot is the same 1 mil 8-year levy for special education that was previously approved by voters in 1990, 1998, 2006, and 2014. If approved by voters on May 4, the 1 mil renewal would provide $3.4 million annually for special education programs and services. Nearly half of this amount goes directly to our 9 local school districts to cover a portion of their special education costs. A breakdown of what is covered by the annual $3.4 million generated by the 1 mil special education renewal looks like this. 6% for transportation, 13% for instructional programs offered by the West Shore ESD, 34% for instructional support services offered by the West Shore ESD, and 47% back to our 9 local school districts to cover a portion of their special education costs. Over the last 8 years, the West Shore ESD has returned $13.3 million in special education funds back to local school districts for special education programs and services. Here is a chart showing the breakdown of the $13.3 million special education partial reimbursements sent to our 9 local school districts over the last 8 years. This chart may be hard to see in this slide, so a copy is available on the ESD website. Along with reimbursing school districts for a portion of their direct special education costs, most of the West Shore ESD's programs and services for students with disabilities are offered in schools in their local school districts. Additionally, the 1 mil 8-year renewal millage for special education funds the range of special education programs and services state and federal law mandates. The renewal would help the West Shore ESD and our 9 local school district partners fund these required programs and services. The West Shore ESD and our 9 local school districts currently serve more than 1,400 students with disabilities in our 3-county region in keeping with state and federal mandates. This represents about 1/6 of our region's pre-K through 12th grade students. Success for all students is the shared goal of the West Shore ESD and our local districts, and the special education millage would generate resources for this commitment and partnership. Special education includes these disability categories. As you might expect, addressing the unique needs of students with any of these disabilities takes a trained and professional staff. This is another requirement the special education millage funds. The West Shore ESD operates 16 programs throughout our 3 counties. This allows local districts and the ESD to pool resources and provide the legally mandated programs, equipment, and professional staff to meet the needs of each student. More information about this on our website, wsesd.org. If approved by voters, the special education millage would continue to fund the model of the ESD working in partnership with our local districts to provide special education programs and services to students with disabilities. Voters in our 3-county, Northern Michigan region have previously approved a 1 mil 8-year levy dedicated to special education programs and services 4 separate times and have maintained dedicated funding for special education for more than 30 years. Tuesday, May 4 is the time for you to consider whether to renew the special education millage for the next 8 years. Thank you for your consideration of the special education millage renewal proposal.